Hi guys, thank you for watching, and in this video we are gonna cover how to use Extrude Boss or Base. So Extrude Boss or Base is the main horses of the Solidworks. So let's get into it and let's see how it works. So right now we are into the part environment, and you already know, like, we have a three basic fundamental planes. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna sketch on front plane, and I'm gonna go into the sketch. You can go into the sketch from this pop-up, or what you can do is you can just select any a fundamental plane, and then you can go into the ribbon section, and then from here you can go into the sketch. So the first thing what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna take a circle, and then I'm gonna start a circle from the origin, and then I would drag it wherever I want. Suppose I want to have whatever the dimension. So when I was just dragging it, I'm gonna go back. I just want to show you one thing. Let's start it from the again, and then I'm gonna go back into the circle, and then I'm gonna start it from the center. So you can see, like, this is the radius. As you can see, like, whenever I'm gonna move my mouse, so you can see there is a value, so you can consider that value. It's up to you, or you can just drag it as much as you want, and then later on what you can do is, like, as you can see, this is the blue lines around the circle, so it means it is not defined. So what you can do is you can go into the smart dimensions, and then you can explain the diameter or radius of your circle, and in that way you can have your accurate circle whatever the dimension you want to have. Suppose I want to have it for 120 mm, and then you can change the units, whatever the unit you want, suppose. But right now I am into MMGS, so it's mm, so I don't need to select. As you can see, I am into MMGS unit system. So you can be in different IPS system or inch system or whatever. You can be in any system, and you can change that, which I already covered in the previous videos. Like, you can just click here into the bottom right corner, and then you can choose into the D system, MKS, CGS, MMGS, inch pound system, or whatever. So right now we just made a circle, and our diameter is 120 mm. So now what we are gonna do is we are gonna go into the features here, into the tab menus, so features, and then you can go into the extrude boss or base. So we are gonna cover this in detail in this video, and then I'm gonna click on extrude boss or base. So you can see, like, as soon as I'm gonna click, so you can see there is an arrow, like, we can extrude it, or in other words you can say we can extend it into top direction or into bottom direction, and you can see there is an arrow. So if you want to extend it, what you can do is you can bring your mouse on the arrow, and then you can hold the arrow, and then you can go upward or you can go downwards. And then you can see there is a virtual scale as well. So suppose right now it's at 30, it's 40, 50, whatever the dimension, whatever the length you want, or you can leave it there, and then it is gonna provide us the option. So what we can do is we can enter our desired values manually, and then what you can do is you can extend it into the one direction, or you can extend it to the both directions. Suppose I want to leave it at 49, so 49 is here, or if you want to change the value here into the feature manager, you can see this is the first direction, which is we are gonna upward, and here you can change the value. Suppose I want to have 60 mm. So this is 60 mm, it is extended, and this is gonna upward from the sketch. So if you want to change the direction, what you can do is, as here you can see under the direction one, there is a arrows, so you can click on these arrows, so they are gonna change the direction, so it just move to the downwards. Or there is another option, suppose I'm gonna go back, there is another option. So if you want to extend it or extrude it as a draft, so what you can do is you can just click on the draft, and then you can change the degrees after draft. So, like, if you want to extrude it via draft, so it can be inward draft or inward draft, and how much degree you want to draft it. Right now it's a 30 degree, so if you want to extend it, it's 45 degree now, so you can extrude it like this. Or this is inwards draft. If you want to go for outward drafts, you can see here there is an option for outwards, so you can just click outward draft. So in this way it can extend like this outwards, And one more thing, like this is just one direction. As I already mentioned, like this is only one direction and still you can change your direction. But if you want to have on the both directions, and it's what you can do is you can go here into direction 2 and you can just click on the direction 2. And then it's gonna mention like this is the direction 2. Again, you can just extend it as much as you want, or what you can do is you can just enter your values here. So let's say 80mm we want to extend in this direction, and draft outward, and you want to go blind, or what you want to up to net, up to vertex, up to surface. There is an option like how much you want to extend, like blindly. So whenever you are gonna choose blindly, then you need to give your values manually like this. Or if you want to extrude or extend it for the next vertex or surface or offset from the surface or up to the next body, you can choose all these options. But I don't like this angle. Let's say, let's decrease it a bit. 18 degree. Let's go 18 degree into upside as well. Or maybe 30 degree, let's say. Okay. And then if I'm done with it, what I can do is I can just click here the green check mark and it's gonna be extruded in both directions because we already selected for the both directions. Sorry for distraction, but if you think my videos are helpful for you, or if you are a serious SolidWorks learner, then I'm gonna highly recommend you can go into the description of this video and you would find a link of my course where I have over 10 hours of videos in which I have explained each and every command in a very detailed video. Or if you have any projects or assignments, so feel free to write me on my email, which is given into the description of this video. Thank you. Or if you are not ready, if you don't like the draft, what you can do is, or whatever the dimension you don't like, what you can do is you can again go back into the feature manager. You can click on your feature. You can just click on it and then you can see there are different options. So the first option is edit feature and then edit sketch. You can edit the sketch as well. So what you can do is you can just click, right click on here, this tiny arrow, and then it's going to show you the sketch. So if you are going to go into the sketch, this was our sketch, and if you want to edit sketch, you can just click on it. You can click on it and then you can go here is the top option, which is edit sketch. So it's going to bring you onto the sketch. So you can edit the sketch, you can change the sketch, you can modify the sketch. I'm going to go back. I don't want to change it. So this was the option to change or modify the sketch, or if you want to change the feature. So what I'm going to do is, like, I'm going to go into the feature and then edit features. But before that, if you want to bring it into the center of the screen, so you can do is you can press F on your keyboard. So it's going to focus. And then I'm going to go into the feature and then I'm going to go into edit features. So here we already used the draft. I don't want to use draft, so I can unclick it again. I can click it again. So draft is we are just going to delete the draft in the both directions, upward and downward. And then I'm going to uncheck the direction 2 as well. And then I'm just going to extend it. I want to make it simple, so I just want to extend it 80. And then I'm going to click the green check mark. So in this way, like, we can extend it. Actually, I want to make it simple because I want to teach you some more steps. So that's why I just keep it simple. And then I'm going to go again into the features. So you can see right now it is extended or extruded from the plane, as you can see here from the sketch. As you can see here, it is extruded from sketch plane. And if you want to extrude it from a surface, from a plane or whatever, you can change this option, choose this option. Or if you want to extrude it from the vertex, you can choose this option, or you can extrude it or extend it from an offset. Let's say I want to extrude it from offset. So I can give any value. Suppose I want to extrude it like 40mm. So thus my sketch is here and it's gonna be extruded after 44mm. But I don't like this at this moment, so I just want to let you know. And then again, I am going to extrude it from the sketch plane and blindly. And I already put my manual values here. And then I'm going to click the green check mark. Okay, so this is my first extrude. So, you know, like in the previous videos, I already mentioned, like, you can sketch on two things. The first is fundamental planes, or you can sketch on any face. So right now we have our own solid. So to sketch on the face, you should have your solid. So what you can do is you can select any face and then you can start sketching. Suppose I want to sketch on here, so I can just select this face. But this face is a round face, so I can't sketch here. So if I want to sketch on this face, so what I can do is I can just go, I can select a fundamental plane and I can sketch on that, and then I can extrude on this face. So let's say I want to go into the top plane. This is my top plane, and then I'm going to go into the sketch. And then I'm going to go into the sketch and top plane sketch, and then I'm going to go into the center rectangle. And then I want to have a center rectangle somewhere. Suppose I want to have here. I can just have a center point rectangle. And then I'm going to click the green check mark. Okay, so I want to have this center rectangle between two points, like top and down. So what I can do is, like, I can have a center line, which is going to start from here. And I want to bring it till this point, and then I'm going to click the escape button on my keyboard. I want to have another center line, which is going to move from here till here. So in this way, I just made a center line between two points, from there to there and here to here, because I want to have this rectangle into the center from these two points. And we already learned the relationship in the previous video. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna select this line, hold the control key, I'm gonna select this line, and then I can add a relation between these two lines, like equal. So in this way, this rectangle is gonna move into the middle. So as you already see, and then I'm gonna click OK. And then next thing is, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna apply extrude boss or base on this sketch. So you can see, like, as soon as I'm gonna go into the extrude boss or base, so I can extrude it in any direction. Suppose I want to change the direction, I want to extrude in this way, and then manually I can increase my values. So as soon or as far you want to extend it, you can select your value, you can enter manually, or you can change value by using these arrows, and then you can click the green check mark. So in this way, what you can do is you can just add another extrude boss or base on this face as well, as you can see. So actually, there was an option, like, if you want to merge these two bodies. So I just click, it was already clicked, checked. So that's why it is just one body. Here into the feature manager, you can go into the solid bodies, and you can see there is just one body. As you can see here, one is written. Or if you want to go back and you want to have separate bodies, so what I'm gonna go is I'm gonna go back into the extrude features, edit feature, and then here it was the option, like, if you don't want to merge the results, so what you can do is you can just unclick the merge results, and then you can click the green check mark. So in this way, you can see now these are two different bodies, and here into the solid into the feature manager, you can see in front of the solid bodies we have two bodies now. Again, I'm going to go back into the extrude boss or base edit feature. I'm okay with the merge. And there is another option, like, from where you want to extrude. Again, if you want to extrude from the sketch, or if you want to extrude from offset, as we already know this offset. So if I'm going to go and I'm going to go and I'm going to offset it from whatever value you can offset, I want to change the direction. Suppose I want to offset, although my sketch is there on the top plane and I want to extrude it from a specific offset, and then I can click the green check mark. So in this way, as you can see, we have two different bodies because we did not merge them, and that is extruded or extended from a certain offset from the top plane where we made our sketch. So this is really interesting, and this is a really powerful tool of the Solidworks, which you are going to use in every sketch or every model, whatever you are going to design at Solidworks. And that's all for today's video. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe to our channel for more videos like this one. And if you are a serious Solidworks learner, then don't forget to check the course link in the description. Thank you. Sorry for distraction, but if you think my videos are helpful for you, or if you are a serious SolidWorks learner, then I'm gonna highly recommend you can go into the description of this video and you would find a link of my course where I have over 10 hours of videos in which I have explained each and every command in a very detailed video. Or if you have any projects or assignments, so feel free to write me on my email, which is given into the description of this video. Thank you.